हाय, हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
हेलो
या
यस सेमिया
ओके, आर यू तृप्ति?
यस आई एम स्टूडेंट
दैट्स रियली ग्रेट। एक्चुअली दिस इज रिचा हेंगा। आई एम फ्रॉम इंडिया, लिव इन दिल्ली।
यस
आई एम यूट्यूब ब्लॉगर। आई जस्ट प्रोवाइड मोटिवेशन स्पीच ऑन माई यूट्यूब चैनल। नाउ डेज आई जस्ट स्टार्ट अ सेशंस फॉर माई यूट्यूबर फॉर माई स्टूडेंट्स, सो दैट दे ऑल्सो कैन लर्न English communication, and they also can say proudly that we are able to speak in English within 3 months. So this is the sessions. I hope you will get to know that I'm really very curious to do these sessions for them, and really thank you so much thank you so much to come to join these sessions. And I'm really glad that you also joined this meeting, and you are the most welcome, awesome blossom English learner. So please, ma'am, could you introduce yourself?
Yeah, okay. So I'm Trusti, and basically I'm from Maharashtra,
okay,
which is situated in India itself. Yeah, and I'm pursuing my degree of Bachelor's in Chemical Technology from Lakshmi Narayan Institute of Technology in RTM in University. And if I would talk about my hobbies, you know, I'm interested nowadays. I'm focusing more towards improving my communication skills also, and along with that, I'm quite interested in cooking, dancing, and yeah, all those activities.
Wow, that's
yeah,
really
so
great.
That's
so, you do know about the classical dance as well?
No, like dance means, you know, I'm not that much professional dancer, and I don't have that much knowledge about classical dance. But you know, the random dance which we do. Like they enjoy when we enjoy with both family and all, like in some functions, I like that kind of dance.
Wow, that's really
me?
Great. Yeah, of course. Thank you so much. So, actually, I want to know one thing also. Like right now, you also continue your education, or like you also leave your education? Like you are the college students?
Yeah, I'm a college student. Now I'm in first year. I'm pursuing my degree of bachelor's in chemical technology.
Okay, that's really great. Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you. So actually I want to know, and I'm really curious to know about your experience in pandemic. As you know every students also continuing class by online classes. This is the first experience in India. So like
now, yeah, because of, you know, this pandemic situation, now the demand of, you know, online, now everyone just learning everything virtually.
Yeah.
So even, you know, the student of even like the small babies, like the from first same or like, so, sorry, from first year. Sorry, I'm mistaken. Actually, the, you know, the student of actually first class also, now they are also attending their classes by virtually itself. So yeah, quite it is good, and you know, because of this pandemic we don't have any other option rather than this virtual classes. But you know, there are some disadvantages, yeah, along with advantages, as we all know that everything has pros and cons also. So according to my experiences, because it is my first experiences of online classes especially. So because up to 12th I did only offline classes. So, you know, in online classes, what is the main problem? The main problem is connectivity issues. And especially, you know, the people or the students who are from some local area or who are from some village. So, you know, they have to face lots of connectivity problems. This is the main one disadvantages of online classes. And along with that, you know, in online classes, teachers are not able to give that much of, they couldn't focus that much towards of particular student in online class. But when it comes to offline, you know, they can focus towards each student like very comfortable. And this is the second one. Yeah, and if I would talk about the advantages of offline classes, so yeah, in offline classes teacher can focus towards student, and you know, we interact with lots of people in offline classes. Means we go to school or college, then you know, we interact with our friends, we communicate with them. So somewhere, you know, we also improve our communication skills also, we communicate with professors, so somewhere we also boost our confidence. So that is the one advantage of offline classes.
Okay, yeah. That's really good. So what do you think that you are missing nowadays in pandemic? Because I think 2 years has completed, and you didn't like you also didn't meet your friends, school friends, and classmates also, teacher as well, and you also missing so much like ground and sports like that. So what do you think about that?
Actually, you know, I'm missing everyone, my friends, and even not only my friends, but along with that, you know, now even we are restricted to go to our relatives' home also. So even I'm missing my cousins, my relatives, everyone. Yeah, because, you know, when we talk with them, we feel, and even, you know, even if we are going to the school just for learning, but along with that, you know, in that break, when we just spend time with our friends, we talk with them, so, you know, we feel quite fresh. And actually, we feel more interested in offline classes as compared to online. Because, you know, in online classes, what is the main problem? Half of the students, you know, they just on their videos. No, they didn't on their videos. They just on their classes. And they just, you know, they just gone somewhere. Actually, a lot of time we face that problem as well.
Yeah.
So, this is the one disadvantage of online classes. Yeah, as you said that I couldn't communicate. Yeah, I can communicate virtually with my friends. That is the good thing. But you know, there is a huge difference when we are communicating or when we are meeting our friends or relatives like face to face. So that is the one disadvantage.
Okay. So next question is that you are really very really excited when will colleges also open, and you are really very really exciting to attend the classes and as well as meet to the teachers also. And so you are excited or not?
Okay, so I'm excited about. Okay, so you know, actually I'm really very much excited because you know, now actually I did my admission in a new college. Means I'm in the first year. So up to now, you know, just I gone to my college just for once a time, just for my admission purpose. Other than that, you know, I never gone to my college. I didn't see in my labs or my classes and nothing. So I don't know anything about my college, rather than little bit just which I get to know virtually. You know, I'm quite excited that when I will go there, what will happen, and a little bit nervous also.
Yeah.
So, yeah, actually, I'm looking desperately that when that day will come and when I will go to the college.
Okay. So, what do you think about the discipline? Like, because of offline classes, of course, it's really necessary to wake up in the morning, in early morning, and we have to ready to go outside for a college and for schools. And but in online classes, it's really a really piece of cake that you also can take class. If you didn't take bath, oh my god, so you also can take classes, like you also like have to read.
As I earlier mentioned, that there are half of the students, they didn't attend classes, they just on their classes and they just go somewhere. So actually, you know, if when it comes to online classes, like even if our classes are 10 a.m. So, you know, we just woke up, we can woke up before just 5 minutes or 10 minutes and we can attend our class. But when it comes to offline, we have to just be ready, we have to take a bath and all those things. And then after getting ready, we go to the college. But in offline, but in online actually, it's completely different.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, it is one of the advantages, but somewhere it is, you know, time, it's time saving, it's not consuming our time in traveling also. So yeah, it is one advantage of online classes.
Okay. So what do you think about the timing of importance? Like in online classes, it is really very like you are able to utilize timing just because of online classes. Because right now you have complementary time, I can say that because you are saving timing, because you don't have need to go outside for taking a classes, from academy, college, schools, and you also saving a timing of like while the distance. Second thing is like it's really very necessary when you are in the home and you don't have need to like properly ready. Third thing is that what can I say, like sometimes a lot of responsibility also, like complete the task according to the classes also. So right now what do you think, because of online classes you are able to utilize the timing, or like because of offline classes it's really very easy for you to arrange the timing?
Saying, you know, in online classes, as I said earlier also, it's somewhere, you know, time saving. So, you know, even after attending your online classes also, we have a lot of time to do some extra physical activities. Now, as I mentioned that I'm focusing, you know, since problems started, I'm focusing towards improving my communication skills.
Yeah.
So yeah, actually, we have lots of time to, you know, to do something which is extracurricular, which could be beneficial for us in future. So it is the one advantages of online class. We have lot of time. And as you said, no, like that task and all. So yeah, even in online classes also, we have to, you know, they just give us task or they just give us some assignment and practical, and we have to complete it and we have to submit it. So yeah, like that is the thing which we have to do in both online and offline.
Okay. Once again. So next question is that, like, any messages you have for school students, because especially for like lazy students, and they don't want to continue their studies, and they also have really very great or amazing time in pandemic because they have excuse how to continue the classes just because of mobile data and like just because of Wi-Fi, sometimes electricity also not there. So what do you think about those students?
There must be some students, they are not interested in studies, and that's why they must be not attending class that much properly. So you know, like, it's not necessary that you, if you are brilliant in studies, that means you are very, like, you know, you are very clever. Because, you know, there are some kind of a student, even they are not good in studies, but everyone, you know, there must be some quality which they have. Everyone has something. So if they are not interested in studies, that means they must be interested in something else. So yeah, they have to, you know, focus towards that, but along with that, you know, education. So is also somewhere important. So you have to also focus towards here, but along with that, like, focus, like, what's your interest? Just follow your interest. Yeah, that is the thing which they can do.
Yeah, that's really great. Okay, so like, which I noticed, because I am a teacher also in school and NGO also. So which I noticed into the students, like, because of online classes, they are not able to continue the education. Plus thing is, like, what can I say about, I just forgot, once again. Okay, so what do you think about, like, school also doing really very great job nowadays in pandemic, like teacher also giving classes, but according to them that they also doing education or not. Second thing is, like, 10th or 12th result, okay? Because according to the government, do you know about that previous year, last year also, and as well as in current also, 10th or 12th exams also, like, not held, okay? And result also, like, without any exams, without any preparations. So what do you think? It is really, it will be good for new students? It will be good for, like, intelligent students?
No, actually, you know, like, they cancelled 10th and 12th exam, but they have some plans. Means, you know, they will arrange some entrance exam. Like, you know, 12 students to for further education, they have to give some entrance exam, like MHTCET and JEE. So yeah, they can give that exam, and even means by that exam also, we can judge them that they are clever or they are brilliant student or not. And even maybe according to my knowledge, the student of 10th class, maybe government will arrange some entrance exam for them also in upcoming days. Yeah.
Okay, that's really great. Okay. So,
Now, actually, in the starting, you know, that it is your second point, and you say something which actually I forgot. You asked me something, but I forgot that. Yeah, actually, yeah, now I remember that. You asked me that teacher also doing well, means they are also teaching well or not. Yeah. That was your question. Okay, so, you know, truly saying that is actually varying from teacher to teacher, because, you know, there are some teachers, they are very sincere about their students, about the studies, that how they will teach, and they really wanted that the things which they are teaching, that student have get to know that. But along with that, there are some teachers, like, they are not that much interested. They are just teaching us just because of their duty. So yeah, it's varying from teacher to teacher.
Okay. So what do you think?
Yeah, you must be a teacher.
Okay, yeah, I'm also a teacher. That's why I want to know. Because I know that if I just ask these questions to my students, so definitely because of scary and because of respect, they are also giving to me a lot of regards. That's why they also cannot say to me this class is really very amazing or not, that they are really very enjoying or not. So that's why I just ask the questions to you.
Yeah,
Okay, so next question is that what do you think about that it will be continue online classes about after the pandemic, just because of we also living in 21st century and modern time also, so it will be helpful for us that if we will continue online classes, like not only on a daily basis, like in a 1 week only one classes, so of course everyone can be habitual to online classes. What do you think about it?
No, actually, no, I'm against of means I'm not against of online classes. Okay. But you know, like for every time, means if the pandemic, even after pandemic also, if you know, we will just study from online classes. So you know, like the thing which you say that the students are not attending classes properly. So everything, you know, will be continued and that will not stop. And as I say, there are, you know, lots of disadvantages of online classes, as they talk about interaction with the professor and the student and like all those things. So, you know, somewhere, yeah, both the things, they both have their own pros and cons. But, you know, obviously online classes will also continue. And of that means, you know, there are some websites like Coursera and like that. So, you know, actually these are kind of a website. They have only some online classes. So we have to attend online classes itself. But when it comes to like, you know, college, like mine or like 11th standard and 11th, 12th, so, you know, offline classes somewhere is mandatory because there are lots of, according to my experiences, you know, I feel more comfortable in offline classes as compared to online classes.
Okay. Offline, but you know, why I'm thinking like that about online classes in one day, like, every week, okay. Like, why I'm thinking, because we are like connected to modern technology and as well as like nowadays computer and laptop and mobile, new technology is so much important, and it's really very necessary to know about this type of knowledge also. Before that, that we also don't know how to open the like laptop. Like mostly also students also don't know how to own the mobile also. But you just see nowadays students, children and parents before the pandemic, parents also don't know how to own the smartphone, how to use it, how to code. But right now all buddies are really, really smarter just because of pandemic, because everyone using a lot phone and laptop. So we will okay, just continue please.
Yeah, continue.
We will touch of the online classes, and we will be habitual in future. Like we also like maybe we also can face next time in the future another virus. I hope so it not be like that. But maybe like suppose that thing is again like repeat. So we can be habitual previous time.
Yeah, that would be good if we are making ourselves comfortable with online classes or with online mode. That would be useful for us. But you know, I'm saying if we will be prepared for both online and offline classes.
Exactly.
So you know, it would be more good. Yeah. So then you know, like according to situation, we can make ourselves like that. Yeah, that could be the better option, because you know, nowadays both type of classes are available, offline and even online. So that depend upon us that in which virtually or offline we are understanding that thing. Shruti, sorry.
No, it's okay.
Sorry. Yeah, so that we are.
Yeah, just continue please.
So I was saying that we have to do, you know, both the online and offline classes. We have to be prepared for both of them, because we don't know that in future which situation will come. So if we are prepared for both the things, so it would be beneficial for us.
Wow, that's really great. Okay, yeah, I got your point that your attention is only and only offline classes, not online classes. But yeah, online classes, yeah.
Actually, you know, I'm talking by mine experience because you know actually I'm not properly from actually my city is Nagpur, so I'm not properly from Nagpur. I live near Nagpur, so you know lots of times lots of connectivity issues and lot of time you know we have lots of problems, but just because of this you know online mode we couldn't clarify that with the teacher, because in the class there are at least you know 60 to 70 students, so you know clarifying everyone curious, it's not possible for teachers, you know. Actually personally I face lots of problems when it comes to online, and that's why you know I'm in more favor with offline classes, but I'm not against of online classes.
Okay, yeah, of course I got your point. Yeah, thank you so much. Thank you. Yeah, of course, thank you so much. I'm really very glad, and thank you so much give me your precious time, so that of course students also can be listen this podcast, and of course they also can be enhance knowledge also about the online classes or offline classes. Thank you so much, see you again. I hope you will come again, you will join again our meeting. Thank you, bye.
Yeah, thank you, bye.